The life-changing magic of tidying up, or refactor your code KonMari style. So for those of you who don't know, Marie Kondo is a tidying expert and an organizing consultant, and she wrote a couple of books on her method called KonMari. And she even has her own Netflix show where she goes to people's houses and helps them to organize it. So what is the KonMari method? The method consists of three basic steps. First, gather all the things together at one place for each category at a time. The second step is only keep the things that spark joy in you. And the third step is choose a place for the things you want to keep using the right technique to do so. And of course, this method was not intended with code refactoring in mind, but let's see how we can apply these principles to code refactoring. So the first step is gather all the things together. And since we cannot or should not dump all of our code onto one pile like we can do with clothes, we can look at this from a different angle here. So we can get an overview of the task ahead and gather all the information you need. So this means which files are involved. Do you have all the information you need in order to complete the task? What knowledge do you need? Who else is involved and who can you ask if you're stuck? And also a key part of the KonMari method is to clean by category and not by location. That means clothes and not bedroom. And an example in code for that may be to replace boost file system with std file system for the entire code base at once and not one file at a time. So the second step is only keep the things that spark joy in you. And usually you would do this like you hold the item up, see if it sparks joy in you, and then only keep it if it does. This is a bit hard with code, so you can hack your computer screen at this point, but there's no need. Just focus on the different blocks of code that you're supposed to refactor. So does it spark joy in you? If so, and you still need this code, then that's perfect. You can keep the code. But think about why it sparks joy in you. So why do you like this piece of code? So, and if you don't need the code anymore, then you should definitely delete it. But also think about why you like this piece of code. An example for that may be that this piece of code is easy to read because someone used good function and variable names. But maybe more common is code that does not spark any joy in you. And so if this code is needed, then you have a little bit of work to do here. So you have to think about why it doesn't spark any joy in you, so what you don't like about this piece of code, and how can you refactor it so it does spark joy in you. And if you don't, if you no longer need the code, then just go ahead and delete it, but also reflect on what you didn't like about this piece of code and what you can avoid in the future. And an example for that may be that someone used a raw loop instead of an algorithm. And also one key part of the KonMari method is to thank the piece you're getting rid of for its service, like, for example, your old running socks. And so you can do the same with code. You can thank the code for its service because it served a purpose once, sometimes even for decades. So thank it for its service. And you can also thank the developer who did the work. And so you don't have to do this in person, just thinking about this is fine. And this may sound odd to you, but it's really just about appreciation for the work that others have been done. And the last step is to only keep the things that spark joy in you and choose the right place and the right technique to do so. So with code, we can see it like this. Organize your code, keep your architecture clean, use a consistent coding style, follow the ISO CPP core guidelines, and also use tools to enforce the coding styles you agreed on and try to automate this as much as possible. And use refactoring tools because this will make your refactoring faster, safer, and easier. And lastly, stay up to date. Educate yourself on the new standards and spread the knowledge within your team. So if you want to learn more about the KonMari method and what it is really about, then please go ahead, check out Marie Kondo's books and visit her website and watch her Netflix show. Thank you.